Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Nahmadu wa nusalli ala rasulil kareem wa ba'd. All praises belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gifted us with this wealth of iman. And Allah has given us an opportunity to come to His house. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants that all of us should recognize Him and become conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is why this point has been driven by Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah also in the Quran Kareem explains this. And Allah ta'ala says, أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَاهُ. Doesn't the human being know that Allah is watching? And Allah ta'ala says, وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. And Allah is with you wherever you are. This was in the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all the companions. This condition was developed in the lowest of the companions of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this feeling that Allah is watching at all times. On one occasion, Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu was doing his night rounds. It was his habit that he would patrol the streets of Medina Munawwara. So on one occasion, he decided to take rest outside a house, from wherein he overheard a conversation between mother and daughter. They used to sell milk for a living, and the daughter was filling up the milk. So the mother advised the daughter and said that, why don't you throw a little bit of water so we can add volume to the milk? We can sell more, we can make more money. We are in need of the money. So the daughter replied to the mother that, have you not heard that Amirul Mu'mineen has forbidden us from doing so? So the mother looked at the daughter and said that, it's late at night, everybody is fast asleep. There's no Amirul Mu'mineen here. We need the money, put some water to the milk. So the daughter replied that, oh my mother, Amirul Mu'mineen Umar might not be here, but the Ilah and the being of Umar, he is present with us. Umar radiallahu anhu took a note of the address of that house, and the next day he came to that house and he sent a proposal for his son, on behalf of his son, for that girl. That if this girl has the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such high level of consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then she is worthy of being my daughter. Another occasion, some say it is Umar, some say it is Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhu. Nonetheless, they were traveling and they came across a shepherd who was grazing his flock. So they wanted to test the level of taqwa of this person. And all of us, to some stage in our life, we also have been put to a very similar kind of test. The level of consciousness. What is taqwa? Taqwa means to fear Allah in the absence, in solitude, when no one is watching. Only Allah is there. So they told the shepherd, listen here, you've got so much of sheep here. Why don't you sell us one? So he said, I can't. Why not? See, it's not mine. See, but your master won't know. We'll give you some money. The master asks you, where's that one sheep is missing? You just say that, akalahu dhib. A wolf came and snatched away that sheep and had eaten him up. The master will believe you, because this normally happens. Wolf comes, he finds his food and he takes it away. It happens. It's not a far-fetched story. It's not an excuse that will not be bought out. He'll buy your excuse. So he said this, testing him. So the shepherd said an amazing statement. Simple shepherd, person who's the whole day is spent with animals. But look at the connection with Allah. How many times that deal has been put in front of us? In the form of bribery, in the form of corruption, in the form of hiding the fault of an item, in the form of forgery, fraud, temptation, pornography, internet material, haram, temptation of a woman. So many times, I'm sure each and every one of us have been put in some test or the other of our iman. We know how we reacted. What was the level of iman in that condition? The shepherd, when Abdullah bin Umar or Umar radiallahu anhu told him, that your master is not there to see. So he said, فَأَيْنَ اللَّهُ. There's a message we all have to go home today. فَأَيْنَ اللَّهُ. Then where is Allah? If my master is not seeing, then where is Allah? So he went and he found out who is the master of the slave and purchased him. I want to buy your slave. He said, okay, so much. He bought the slave and freed him. And told him, أَعْتَقَدْكَ هَذِهِ الْكَلِمَةِ فِي الدُّنْيَا. This one statement of yours got your, bought your freedom in this dunya, in this world. فَأَيْنَ اللَّهُ. Where is Allah? This consciousness of Allah got your freedom in this dunya. إِنِّي لَأَرْجُ مِنَ اللَّهِ. I hope from Allah that this very statement will free you from the fire of Jahannam in the akhirat as well. So my brothers, this has to come in our hearts. Abdullah bin Mubarak rahmatullah alayhi was a great saint and a great muhaddith of his time. 6 months he would go in the path of Allah and 6 months he would do business and teach hadith. This was his practice. His father used to work in an orchard of a person. So the master asked him, bring me a pomegranate. He brought him a pomegranate. He tasted it, it was sour. Bring us your sweetest pomegranate. He went and he bought the pomegranate. Again it was sour. 3, 4, 5. Eventually the master got agitated and said, what is wrong with you? I'm asking you to bring the sweet pomegranate, you bring all the sour ones. He said, I do not know which is sour and sweet. He said, what you mean? He says, I am hired to look after the orchard. I do not have permission to taste. I have never ever tasted any pomegranate in your orchard. Can you imagine the fear of Allah? How many of us, we work in our businesses, we utilize work time for what? Our own. Sometimes we abuse the telephone, which is the company's telephone. The petrol, which is the company's petrol. The car, the wear and tear, all of that we are utilizing it for our own personal needs, which has absolutely nothing to do with the company and the not work orientated at all. All of that we are going to be accountable for. So my respected brothers, how does taqwa, this consciousness of Allah, this love of Allah, this awareness of Allah is going to come in our hearts? Where we understand, we don't have the fear. As Ali radiallahu anhu said, Suqul Muslimina ka masajidihim. In the time of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to say that the workplaces of the believers has the same atmosphere like the masjid. Can we say that today? Why? Because just like how no person would dare disobey Allah in the masjid, in the time of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no person would even dare disobey Allah in his workplace. Why? Because Allah is present wherever we are. Allah is watching us. So how we are going to develop this consciousness, my beloved brothers? We have to make an effort. It doesn't come like that. You can't buy it in the marketplace. You can't shop it online. This consciousness of Allah, this taqwa, comes with a price. Allah says, اتقوا الله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. O people of Allah, O people of Iman, adopt taqwa. Get the consciousness of Allah in your hearts. And be amongst those people that are true believers. The people that have found Allah, the people that are making effort for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the efforts that are being made and facilitated in our environments so that we can connect ourselves to Allah. Allah says you cannot get taqwa on your own. We need an environment. For this, alhamdulillah, we know the ijtima is going to take place. Our yearly annual ijtima that takes place in Binoni, Actonville this year. Next week Friday it will be taking place. From next week Friday it will start. The 25th, 26th, 27th. From Friday till Monday morning the dua will take place. And my respected brothers, many of us have been to many ijtimas before also, alhamdulillah. But the purpose of the ijtima is this. This taqwa must come in our life. This tawbah, repentance should take place. Our connection must be made with Allah. Our reconciliation with Allah should be taking place. For this, alhamdulillah, environment will be created. And the ulama and the pious people that have sacrificed their lives and dedicated their health, wealth, time, their energies and capacities for the service of deen, locally and internationally in the whole world, they will be addressing us. So we humbly appeal to all our brothers that are here, let us make an effort. It's not a matter of just being there, done it, and in the tikka or whatever, whatever is the highlight of the ijtima, normally in the menu, you guys know better. So it's not a matter of that, but it is a matter of going there, taking part in the programs. Even if we have to sacrifice our weekend, maybe we had some other plans, some leisure. How much of leisure and pleasure we have done in our life? When we are going to take out some time for the sake of making my connection and my bond with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may Allah give us tawfiq, my brothers. Let's all make an intention, make a concerted effort, take others with us also, and go there with an open mind. It's not a matter of gathering Muslims. Allah's help is not worth quantity. Allah's help is worth quality. Millions of Muslims cannot draw that decision from Allah, which 313 people draw the decision from Allah. It's not a matter of gathering thousands and thousands. It's a matter of us making that the turning point of our life. That is the question. The tawbah taking place, the resolution being made, person making a concerted effort and a determination to connect himself with Allah, that is what is required. So may Allah give us tawfiq.